Hey, what's up guys? Christian here for Kriscoart. Today we're looking at different ways that you can time and pace your music perfectly to your short film. Now, when editing a sequence that has a soundtrack to it, what I'd usually like to do, and this is just my personal preference, I like to edit first and then add the soundtrack later. I usually allow the music that I'm going to pick to inspire some of the style of editing, but I don't really like to edit off of a soundtrack because I feel like that could be limiting. Even subconsciously, if you have a track and you're editing off of the speed and the rhythm and certain cues of that track, then you're kind of limiting yourself and being creative and following the natural rhythm of the scene, of the action taking place of the scene, or even just the rhythm that the story really needs. So I prefer to just find that kind of flow at first and then adding the soundtrack later. And then of course, if I need to readjust certain things, if I absolutely have to hit certain cues or moments in the scene that need to match with certain parts of the track, I can always like kind of move those a little bit around just to make sure that those match in the final result. But as far as the overall thing, I usually prefer to kind of just see where it takes, see where the edit takes me without being restricted or influenced by something that someone else created. Depending on what you're doing, your project can be an artistic collaboration between different people. So, workflows always change, but this is personally what has helped me a ton, especially when using royalty-free music and not really hiring a composer. This is just something that has worked for me personally so far. Now, the internet is a great place and you can find a ton of royalty-free music all over the place, but for this short, I just cannot find something that would match. Now, either the soundtrack sounded fitting in terms of sound, but wasn't really hitting the cues that I wanted to hit, or vice versa. So it's really kind of a challenge to find something that can, in this particular example, really showcase the full range of emotions that the character, the protagonist in the short is going through. And thankfully, after looking through libraries and libraries of royalty-free music, that's when I found FilmStro, and I'm so happy I did because it really solved that problem. And that is what I ended up using in the final short. So that is the tool that we're gonna be talking about today, and I'm super excited to show it to you because this tool really gives you full control over the music that you're adding into your timeline, and we're gonna see how in just a second. Now, they were awesome enough to sponsor this video, but I've used them way before they sponsored me, and I really love this tool, and I just genuinely wanna share it with you guys because this is really one of the best tools, and I honestly, to my knowledge, one of the first tools that really allows you to customize music, to customize soundtracks in a really simple way. FilmStro comes with three slider parameters, and it's momentum, depth, and power. So it's essentially the key components of a soundtrack, and you can fully animate those and control them to really fit and match what you have in your sequence. And this was especially important for me for this short vignette that I did in Italy, Timeless, where this guy is like rediscovering this car and he's going through these different ranges of emotion. And I really wanted to show that and highlight that because really the whole story is this moment of discovery and really just going inside the emotions of this character. And to highlight that, I really wanted the music to make those elements and those moments stand out. So in this scene, for example, I really wanted to empathize with the joy of seeing something you haven't seen in a while and the anticipation of reuniting, in this case with the car. Then you have the connection and memories with it, and then the music dips down, becoming more gentle, allowing us to focus on the care that he has for the car in a much more intimate way. So these are, again, all ways that you can really control these sliders and really bring him down to kind of close in on certain feelings. Then after he enters the car and grips the steering wheel, the music changes slightly again because we really want to dial in that sense of nostalgia that he might be feeling. And then it rises again as soon as he turns on the ignition and the track goes to full power. And yeah, that's the power slider goes all the way up and we hear the full orchestra of the track. And it's kind of to match the revival of this car and the power that it contains and also the excitement that the man driving it has. So those are very different emotions timed in a sequence where they're very close to each other. You know, doing that with a conventional royalty-free pre-made track can be really challenging. So now that you know what it does, I actually want to jump into Premiere because they recently released a panel that works right inside of Premiere, and then you can never leave the program, do your music changes, and then drag and drop them onto your timeline. So let's do exactly that. Let's jump into Premiere, and I really want to show you how I kind of matched these moments with FilmStro into the timeline for the short Timeless. shot this piece with the intention of adding sound effects, but after hearing how well the score mirrored the feelings in the visuals, I thought that any sound might take away from the ethos of the story rather than forwarding it. So that's kind of why I decided to just completely go without sound and literally have the music just take full charge of the representation of the emotions of the character. So in Premiere, I was able to play the video in conjunction with FilmStro. So they play at the same time, and then you're able to make live changes to the slider as the video is playing. So you can literally be screening your sequence and animating those sliders in real time just by moving them. And of course, once that's done, you can always go back and tweak, delete, and move certain keyframes that it generated from recording all those movements that you did while playing the video. So once you're done, you can export it and save that version, and you can just simply drag and drop it from the panel directly onto your timeline without ever leaving Premiere, which I love. And then of course, if you want to make additional changes, you can always go back into the FilmStro panel and you can just start from scratch or just make some changes to the keyframes that you already have there for that track. So let's say that you actually change your mind about the soundtrack that you picked, or you might have found a better one in the FilmStro library, but you've already done all that work of all the keyframes, of really nailing all of those key moments in your timeline. Well, the nice thing is that you can actually save those as a preset, so all of that keyframe information can be saved right within a FilmStro, and then you can add any other soundtrack from their library, and you can apply those same keyframes and those slider movements to really any track. So that saves a ton of time, and you can addition multiple tracks without having to redo all of that work of timing it and animating all those sliders. So I think that's really, really cool. And again, it just allows you to be creative and just check out different soundtracks and just see and pick the one that works best for you. So this, amongst all the other features that FilmStro has, is why I really love it and why I was so excited to share with you guys. So with that being said, they are actually offering you 20% off of their annual licenses, which is awesome. It's already affordable. And just to put things into perspective, for the same amount of money that you would be paying for a FilmStro monthly membership, you could probably only purchase one or two royalty-free soundtracks from another library. And most of the time in that price range from any other website so far, they've all sounded kind of corporate and really cheap and just not really cinematic. And of course, if you want to get more expensive royalty-free tracks, then of course you're gonna have to pay a lot more money or hire a composer, which is even more money. So that's why I love FilmStro, and I think it answers to a problem that a lot of us filmmakers have. All right guys, that is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you learned something from it. And if this is your first time on this channel, I make filmmaking videos, VFX, post videos, and I try to make them once a week, which is a really quick turnaround, which is why I'm always looking for tools like this one and others. So if you want me to make more videos like this, reviewing tools, different gear, or just some of my workflow when editing some of these videos or making some of these videos, definitely let me know in the comment section below. But with that being said, use a 20% discount code, check out FilmStro, and I will see you in the next video.